Morning, good afternoon, good evening. Welcome, welcome, wherever in the world you are. How y'all doing today? So, I feel kind of dumb. And, you know, I have 7 carriers down here. And they are in 7 different systems. And it seems that no matter what I do, they are getting camped. So, I'm moving to a system right now where I am the only one in it. And I believe that I'll have somebody here in just a moment that will be following me. So, if that's the case, I'm going to move very far in the region. And, so, I have carriers. Most of them are Thanatos. Most of them, were fit when I purchased them. So, I only built one of them. And, the rest of them I purchased from other players. So... and then I also have a Nithogger, which I have not gotten set up yet. So, let's see here. And I need rigs for it. And really, it's probably going to cost me, a billion or so to fit it out. So, and that'll be good. I have... In Minmatar, I have level 5, so it I have Minmatar Carrier 5, so it's I'm pretty powerful with that. But then also, I have Thanatos, I have Galante 3 right now, I have a Mar 4 carrier, and I don't know, I'll have what have I got? I got 5 days left, and I'll have Galante Carrier 4. So I'll eventually get all of them up to 5. It does make a difference. On this kind of firepower, a 5% boost in your, DPS from having one of those levels is a lot. So it's pretty good. So I also have another... I logged in all my characters this morning and set them up in different areas. And then, I kid you not, all of the characters that are camping us showed up all at the same time. They were not there. They all showed up within 10 minutes of each other. So, and there's 4 or 5 of them. This is Eve, you know? This is how these things work. So, and I can, if I can't find anything else to do, I will rat with this Ishtar, and, it will, this thing's amazing, and I look forward to showing it to you, but I hope to do it without neutrals in the system. May not be something that can happen. So, we shall see. Okay. Let's go out and... YouTube notification worked. Excellent. Hello, Janos from Romania. Josh, Razman, Pierre, Flow Snake. Thank you for being here. Okay, do I have... I do not have anything on this one. Okay. See what happens here. So this is carrier routing. Optimal conditions. I should be able to get 45 million ticks. And I'm not going to loot. So looting takes a lot of time. And so, you know, there's not much that I can do about that. The total value of the loot tends to be around 6 million from one of these sites. So, so 6 million from the site. Now, if I were to also salvage it, then that's worth a lot more. That's worth anywhere from 8 to 11 million. And salvaging, you know, works pretty good. So I actually like salvaging. It's because the money from salvaging or the items from salvaging are very small, very easy to transport, which means that they're very liquid in turning them into cash. So, okay, this is a ring type. This is a ring type spawn. Okay. These guys start targeting me. I'm gonna let them target me up before I do anything here. Okay, got a good number of targets there. Launching the fighters. I'm gonna go for the smaller stuff first. So these ships. Or these fighter ships that we've got here, they are pretty expensive. They're about 13 to 14 million each, and they are squads of 9. So I have 27 of them out there. So it's about, you know, 250 million worth, something like that. If you haven't seen fighter squadrons before, they have both a ammunition. They have two ammunition types. These ones have lasers, but then they also have missiles, and all of them have missiles as a secondary. Like the Minotaur type and stuff, they have guns. So. And so they're unlimited on their initial firepower, but on the missile portion, they have to refuel. But you can see I'm getting about 1.1 million for each one of these. So you can see how the ticks would be pretty high. I just gotta take out the smaller stuff first. It's important to get the smaller ones first. Reason being that they are the ones most likely to do damage to my fighters and I don't want to lose any fighters. So each fighter, 13 million to 14 million, that's what they cost. So carrier ratting is cheating? Absolutely not. There's a lot more risk of getting hot dropped with carrier. People want carriers. They want these kills on their kill board, and they'll do a lot more crazy things to catch you. So I would not call it cheating at all. So, and there's a big investment, like this carrier. About 2.5 billion, and this one is not an optimal fit. I mean, I have one more here. I'll have to look at the fit. I think this needs the fighter support units replaced, and the drone damage amplifiers may be replaced. A couple of them. So I've got 500 to 800 million that I'll be putting out on refitting a portion of this. And in the end, it'll be worth 3 billion, 3.2 billion, something like that. How did you have a Vexor Navy issue stolen? Did you leave it floating out in space somewhere? James, you're in Tampa, huh? All right. Yes, we're local then. So far, they have not targeted my fighters, which is good. Got two more spawns here, I think. Now this one's a little bit more dangerous because it has frigates. Yeah, so I usually carry a bunch of MTUs. I actually don't have MTUs on this. But yes, so the salvage can last up to 2 hours out here. An MTU can last 48 hours. But if you want the salvage, you have to show up within 2 hours. So I'll put out like six and then go and clean up six and do it in the same order. So if I'm going to loot everything. So if I loot everything and the time that it takes to pick everything up and stuff, you know, I can get 45 to 55 million ticks. But that's not all the time, you know? All right, am I gonna bring these back? No, I don't think so. Only got one more spawn to go. I'm out of missiles. But we'll just do this last spawn. I think it's the last one. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, next one will be the last one. Close enough now. Not very accurate when they're far out. They just gotta always target the small stuff first. Why do I use an Ishtar over a VNI? I don't own a VNI. Why do I have it? Because a Ishtar can do sanctums if I wanted to. May not be the best use of my time, but it can do a lot bigger stuff, and so that's why I have it. So the tick hasn't come in yet. I hope to finish all this up before tick comes in. So this is like, I don't know what it'd be, like 33, 35 million off of payout on this. Something like that. If I were to take the time to loot, it'd be about 6 million in loot and around 8 to 10 million in salvage. Which a lot of times I like to bring in a salvage right behind everything. But I don't have that set up today. I don't have any salvage ships here, and I do drone salvaging. And so by doing drone salvaging, I do not have to be there, which is nice. Okay, I think this is the last one. We'll find out. Oh, there's two more. Well, they didn't shoot at my fighters at all, which is kind of amazing. All right, there we go. Okay. Let's return the fighters. Turn on my fan here. Okay, so I got them returning. They're flying at about 12,500 velocity. Okay, so now they're refueling. Let's go to the next one, get it started, see how big we can make this tick. I know, it doesn't seem a waste just leave all that loot out there, but it's the way it goes. When a fighter is marked red instead of white, it's taking damage. Or it has damage. It will repair itself. They do auto-repair themselves, but it takes a long time. Oh yeah, Nick Pye, I shaved all the scruff. You know, I stopped shaving for, I don't know, 2 months, something like that. Yeah, started shaving again. Hey. Station type. There's also mining here on this type. The only thing I don't like about this kind of, it's hard to see the stuff. Oh, this isn't turned on. There we go. Now I tend to lose, I've lost fighters more often on this type of spawn. Just kind of a fact though. Taking damage here, 6% only. It's okay. Shield alarm might be going off here in just a moment. Don't worry, it's not your AFK mining fleet. Dying to fly a carrier. This is how the money's made. That's only 3% damage. It's healing itself. So, in a super, can fly heavy fighters. These are light fighters. Can do even more DPS. And it can... let's see here. So, supers, yeah, have a lot more punch. These. I don't want to lose any of them. Which makes more, this or station trading? Definitely buying and selling makes more. But you have to have the money to do it. So both make money. This is kind of like guaranteed money for my actions, where station trading is a bit more of, you know, taking chances on the market. Sometimes you take a chance and you do really well, and other times you don't. So, okay, that is my shield alarm, not you. Don't panic. Down to 1% damage there. Now it's completely fixed up. Thank you. So, and these are a little bit different than drones. You don't, they're not quite treated the same way. So they're similar, but they're not exactly the same. They won't auto-attack. You have to tell them to attack. You have to tell them what kind of ammo type to use and such. Not streaming Crowfall today. I'll be streaming Crowfall when the EKs come out. So, and I kind of fine-tune the use of the missiles. I don't necessarily fire them all off at once. And I also turn on propulsion when I think it's a long way to go for the fighters. I try and keep it so that I can use propulsion on the way back for them, because it'll take them a long time to fly back to your ship otherwise. And if you are out and about here, you want your fighters back. They will, if you warp off, you still can command them to come to you, and they will go into warp. But it can take them a while, and it can be difficult to get them all the way into you if they land at warp, 10,000 kilometers away from you, which has happened to me before. I'm interested to see what this tick will be. I've been actively killing the whole time. Okay, well, let's see here. Got a hostile in system. 45 million tick. Yeah, I'm going for the dual TIs after they revealed the info about them. Most definitely.
Warp drive active.
Guy left. Now, I don't do these smaller sites typically because there's too many small ships, and that can cause an issue.
Drive active.
Okay, so my tick there was 48 million. Not too bad. So if you can keep active, you can make, you know, 180 million an hour. But you gotta stay active. Havens are better because they spawn closer? Alright. Well, I may look at that. Let them get me targeted up first. I don't want them looking at my fighters. RioX, thank you for following. Welcome. Now the reason to bounce to safes is that your fighters, you need to get your fighters back in. Also, you got to be aware that whatever hostile ship that's coming in could actually be a saber or something like that, you know, to an interdictor, is it, to bubble, and it, you know. So you need to, depending on where you're going, you know, you may have issues with bubbles. And so it's good to have some safes that are near the station so that you can scan to see whether or not you're going to have to deal with bubbles. Because if you are, you might keep on the move while you're out there, because this thing caught in a bubble, not good. Not good. I do not have an emergency sino on this one either. So, usually part of my normal loadout is to have an emergency sino on them. And I just don't have that on this one. But normally I have that so that I can, if I get tackled, I can light a sino and get everybody in the beginning.
You, sir, rock.
Hey, Doc! Woohoo! Doc got game, everybody. Doc, say hello in chat. should give you a follow. If you don't know Doc, Doc is a great guy, a friend of mine, and he's an even better streamer than I am. I mean, he certainly gets higher numbers than I do. So, I think he's a fantastic guy. So, and in honor of 5 months in a row as a sub, 50 gold to everybody here in his honor. Everybody tell Doc thank you. So, and Silver Picker and Center Path, thank you for following. Welcome. Okay, I see we're over 200 viewers now as well. So we will do a draw here shortly. And so, exclamation point ticket space 1 or higher in Twitch chat. And you can get in on a brand new account code for EVE. It's worth about $20, except for at the moment it's on sale in our store for half price. And so I got a couple other things on special for EVE as well. Specials all end on Monday. So Monday is some point on Monday. They're turning off. So including we got like 28x Plex comes with a free item code. Never bundled anything together before like that, but it's pretty cool.
User Rock.
All right. Hey, Alex. 37, 6 months in a row. All right. Alex is my business partner with the store. I give it up for Alex, because of her. Another 60 gold to everybody here in her honor. So thank you, Alex, for that support. I appreciate it. There's a small one here. Missed him before. Surprised he's not shooting my other stuff. Oh, yep, there he goes. See, he's shooting one of my fighters. That's why you gotta take those out. Turn on their propulsion, get them moving faster. Wait, I have a hostile about to come in. Pretty sure of it. We have some really good intel channels here. Really impressed with the intel that Test has set up. Parakeet, thank you for following. Welcome. Right. 18% damaged and 1% damaged. Okay. Okay, that is all on these. Ticks won't be quite as high on that one. Just because I had to do a little maneuvering around. So, it's mentioned that the Havens packed a little bit closer together and might be better. Let's try it.
Warp drive active.
Cameron, I don't know where you think the sleaze is, but the no-job stuff is not sleazy. It is 100% legit, and we deliver 100% of what we say there. And if you ask, you will find that that there are people here who have purchased, and they can honestly tell you what they think about it. So, oh, actually, we're not going to do this Haven. We're going to do a drawing. So, yeah, okay. We're gonna do this drawing. And but I want to dock up for that. I don't know if I have any MTUs, but I want to dock up for that. I don't want to be sitting out here twiddling my thumbs and get stepped on. I have hostiles next door. So, okay, so we're going to do our first drawing. Exclamation point, ticket space one or higher in Twitch chat. That will get you in on it. And so, I'm going to start writing it up. It's a brand new account for Eve, worth about $20. Comes from our store. Exclamation point coupon in Twitch chat, or there's a link in the description in YouTube. And you can... oh, and look at this. We have hostiles in system. Raptor doing scanning. So we must be going for anomalies. I wonder if I have any warships out here that can scan.
Docking permission requested. Docking request accepted.
Let's see, I have a crow. Oh, he can't. He doesn't have any scanning abilities. Too bad I didn't scan him down previously, and then. Do a just camp them. Okay, so continue getting this drawing set up. So anyway, exclamation point coupon in Twitch chat, or there's a link in the description on YouTube. You can get a link to our store that has all kinds of Eve stuff. And we have some stuff on special right now. Those commands, or those will give you a bonus code and a discount code. Both of them save money. You can choose which way works better for you. And making purchases from the store helps support the show. So you get my thanks as well. All right, this is all written up. Doing good, Brian. Okay. So we are going to close this. And drawing. Zed. Congratulations, Zed. You are the winner. All right. So, here we go on that. Zed, check your Twitch mail. You'll find that contained within. So we will start another one, and then we'll draw again at 300 viewers. So you can get in on that now. Exclamation point, ticket space one or higher in Twitch chat. Yes, Alpha Gust, it's impossible to hide everything. So, yes. So, let's see here. So, okay, well, while that other is being camped here, we've got one hostile in here. Let's go out and have a little fun. Let me show you how it's possible to go AFK. I don't necessarily want to go AFK with, you know, this, looks like I got to, all right, so a couple things I got to do here. I got some drones to repair, and then it looks like they are all messed up, and I have to put them in their groups. Also, I guess I'm going to grab a drink here real quick. Be right back. Okay, so Let's do this. I don't think... we're going to go drop right in the middle of a small one. Something up here. So we'll just drop right in the middle of a small one. This is an Ishtar. And so we're going to drop into something small, and I'm going to show you how it's possible to really kind of AFK the stuff here. Oh God, I didn't repair my shit again. It'll do that.
Permission requested. Docking request accepted.
All right. Erica, you are saying that that I'm here begging for money and I'm not a real man. You are a wonderful person. Yeah, and I don't know, who saw me begging? Yep. So, okay, get repair quote. Ira, you played all day yesterday, lost about 80 million trying to rat, getting killed. You rage quit. So, yeah, well, it is, you know, there's that. Eve is not an easy game. You gotta figure it out. For sure. Stuff not set up in here. Are preparing to drop on me? Okay. Oh, I gotta shake the cup? Oh, yeah. And my virtual... Oh, wait. Here. My water bottle here. Yeah. It's not money in there, though. That's ice. Yeah. I can't drink money.
Oh, right. Nice. Dragons love gold, treasure, and of course, dollar bills.
Oh my goodness. Brian Zerte says, shut up and take my money. He donates $5. All right. So, everybody give it up for Zerte. 50 gold to everybody here for that $5. And then I will put that toward the video card, which is going to improve the show. It's not going to pay my rent. It's not going to, well, it might buy me whiskey sometimes, but, you know, that's a whole different story. And, yeah, I haven't drank much whiskey lately, actually. So that puts us up to 1318 on the goal for the video cards. And, here, update that on here. There we go. Okay. There's my tin can right above my, right above are my tin cup. Yep. Thank you, Brian. I appreciate it. Whiskey equals show improvement? Yeah, might be. Might be. So. Yeah. Okay. Let's see here.
Welcome to the Dragons.
So, we're going to do something simple like a hub. Hubbub. So we're going to warp to within 30 of it.
Warp drive.
I'm going to drop down curators. Turn all my shielding on here. By the way, I am cap stable on all of this. Badass this Ishtar is. Okay, so I have an auto targeting module here, which and it also lets me target more stuff. Maybe I should have left those, not launched those quite so soon. Sometimes send me to home station. Lovely. The ticks obviously will not be as high on this, but it's going to be a lot of fun because I can also get a little bombing action going on out here. That is cap stable as well.
Welcome to the Dragons.
And so really, I could sit here orbiting these guys and pretty well. If they get close to me at all, I'll blow them up. So my drones are having a little bit of a hard time hitting this guy. So let's switch them back over to this one and let's then go toward this guy.
Warp
toward this guy. I'll start taking damage here in a second unless he starts moving away from me. If he starts moving away from me, then what'll happen is my my drones will get better aim on him. Better able to take him out. No, these players are not human. System. So I had a hostile come in. He left again. He was in a Tengu. Gotta make sure you stay far enough away from your drones. Doing this. Pull back a little bit so it's not as loud. My range is around 5,400. Oh, drones got him. Okay, so this unit is auto-targeting, plus it has extra I can target more things at one time. That's what it has extra. This is just a hub. I'm just kind of showing off this Ishtar that can be AFK. I've never completely run it AFK. I have let it run, you know, without touching it for extended periods of time, but I've never left it like totally AFK. Yeah, I'm running sentries with this. Dragos, Matosis, Pluck Killer, and Bisma. Thank you for following. Welcome. So, I mean, I can just kind of sit out here and let them do their thing. These smaller ones are coming toward me. And, you know, maybe I can even just go straight toward them. let my drones continue to do their thing, which I think my drones that they're optimal is like 43 or something like that, or 43 to 50, something somewhere in there. Not 100% sure. So this is also a good ship for ratting in when you don't want to risk something more expensive, although this is an expensive ship. So doesn't have to be this expensive, but this one's 650 million. I've been playing EVE for 10 years or more. Well, I tried EVE for the first time 2003, but I didn't really start playing hardcore until like 3 years ago, something like that. Oh, wait, this one's right here. Bible, you're banned. I don't care if you are the Black Messiah, as you say you are. God cannot come in and spam the channel. Just saying. Okay, this guy should be taking damage now. I'm getting close enough to him. Okay, so it's a phantasm. It's his cruiser. Had a little bit more meat on him. Makanos, spam, 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 wonderful spam, 50 bits. All right, thank you for that spam, Makanos. Equals 5 gold to everybody here in your honor. So thank you, thank you. None of these guys are close to me. My ticks with this, they're not impressively high. This is more of an AFK fit. I think you can do something very similar with Vex or Navy issues. And I think you can do two Smart Bomber Vex or Navy issues and one other ship, a triple, that actually you can get 30 million ticks on each one of them when you run in that combination. But Brain Manager, here's some more spam, just to support Makino's spammy spam. Brain Manager, thank you, buddy. There's 10 gold to everybody here in honor of Brain Manager. And 100 more bits spam. And that brings us up to 1319 on the video card. Getting closer. By the time I can buy one, we'll have the funds. Why did they split their focus? Look at that. How interesting. Ars Technica has a review out for the 1080 Ti. Okay, cool. Yeah, they must have gotten an early one. I'll have to read that. Kind of wish I had propulsion on this guy, but I don't. Sometimes I put an MTU out, so there's a tick of 9 million. Riot Punch Beats, thank you for following. Welcome. So this is just kind of a fun ship. Also, this is good if you get tackled by interceptors. You know, you can start dropping some bombs on them. Looks like I killed the trigger. There we go, taking that guy out with the bombs here. That third one is a micro, only goes 2K. I just turn all of them on at the same time anyway, but Kind of want to refit your Ishtar now. Oh, but you have 141k drone range. Yeah, well, you know. It's different, different ways of going about fitting these up. It's just one. This guy's a lot closer now. My drones keep going for all the big ships. It's like they're not interested in other shit. They want all the big ones. Okay.
Welcome to the Dragons.
And I have the auto targeting turned on. That's how I've got so many targeted with an Ishtar. Is what they determine what they're shooting at next. Never 100% figured that out. Yeah, there is auto-targeting, so I have that turned on. That's what this is right here. It's an auto-targeting system one. I just picked up out of salvage. Put it in here. You can't really buy them on the market. Nobody seems to sell them. They're not used hardly ever, so... Yeah, the reason... Okay, so comment is that the smart bomb is a joke, that I should use railguns instead. This is an AFK fit. You can't fire railguns AFK. You can fire smart bombs AFK. So for manual stuff, yeah, you very well could be right. For this, I'm doing fine. It's doing what I want it to. Chasing these guys all over hell and back. It's really what I should be doing is getting back down to these guys. And I'm not picking up any of this loot. This loot will be worth 2 million. Salvage would probably be worth 2 million. I don't know. I haven't salvaged them. Don't know. All right, that was it. So, got a couple of, let's see. No, I just got one tick so far, 9,400. We'll see what the other tick comes in at. We'll head toward these. I have no propulsion on this. I give up propulsion for this fit this way. Does a cheaper rattlesnake under 600 million have enough tank to do this site? Absolutely. This is a hub. You can do bigger sites. This is the lowest end. A hub is the lowest end in null sites. And so absolutely you could do it with the... You know, you need a good fit. You can't have a total... You could get killed in a totally shit fit in anything. But, yeah. You just need... you need crowd control. Meaning that... you need to be able to control the rats that are scramming you. That would be important. So I'll pick these up. There at the moment. How about in the system? Yep, still being camped there. It's my fourth mid. Imperial Navy Capri Charger. It's probably to hit stable. I don't know. See what happens when I turn that off. I'm not gonna turn it off right this moment, but see what happens. Can auto targeters be used on carriers? Yes, they can. Picked up everything. We're gonna head back to the station. So, you know, this is something that I'll run in a camped system too, because if I lose it, it's not such a big deal. I can keep on my scanners and I can see when something's getting close. I can do anomalies that are further out from the gates than 14.3 AU and further from the station than 14.3 AU. And that way, those are the kind of the two common scan points that people will scan at to decide whether or not they're going to go searching for whatever's out there. And, you know, if I wanted to put an MTU out there and collect all that AFK, I could. I'd just bookmark it and, you know, come back later or whatever. But, yeah. Alright, let's see in this fit here. What happens when I turn this off? No longer stable. 1 minute, 20 seconds is all we're stable for. Isn't that a big difference on that? Pretty amazing, huh? Yeah. So, and this thing's not real tanky. I could lose it, but it gets all of its strength from having... this is a large shield booster. It's pith, X-type, large shield booster, 370 hit points per 3.2 seconds. So, and then the resistances here. So out here I'm using EM and thermal. And that all seems to work. So this is a shield fit. Commonly though, a lot of Galantes are armor fit. So, yeah. Okay. So, we'll see what comes in on that in just a moment. Hey, I'm going to step away for just a moment. I'm actually going to grab myself some lunch really quick. Give me 2 or 3 minutes, and I'll be right back, and we'll continue on. Not using the smart mom's cap will last longer. Absolutely. Yes, and if I'm neutered, I go down very fast. Absolutely. Yep. Okay, I'm back. Let's see, my other tick hasn't come in yet, has it? I'd like to see that other tick. So, take this one out again. This one's not very, I don't know. I have lots of loot here. Is there anything in this station container? There is. Ton of stuff in here. 199 million worth of what looks to be mostly loot. Well, there's some rigs. Lots of smart bombs. Oh, and some skill books. Alright. Yes, well, I've got plenty of junk in here to put in there with it. Templars, though. Probably put them up for sale. any for sale around here. There are some at station for $3 million each. I don't know. We're $3.7 million each. Seems kind of cheap. The Templar ones. Yeah, I'm not gonna waste a merchant slot for that. Yes, this is a carrier. Oh, and lunch today? Leftover lasagna and mashed potatoes. Good stuff. All right. By the way, so I joined test. I mean, I was in Moose Army, and Moose Army joined test. Oh. As soon as I undock, somebody comes in. Okay.
Mission requested. Docking request accepted.
They're in a Stratios. Okay. Hey, we'll give them just a minute, see if they move on. I do, however, recognize this person. Mashed carrier. Yeah. So, what did I get on my other ticks here? So, yeah, so I got a 48 and then a 17. I did half of one there. You know, so, I'm making some money here. I didn't take any losses on any of this stuff so far. So, and then the 9 that Marky Dragon got. And still hasn't gotten the other bounty payment. So that came in at 1519 and it's 1539. It's about to come in. There it is. And so, you know, he's made 12 million. And this is $48 million, so that's $77 million I've made today. It's not too bad. Is it hard to eat with a beard? There is some special things you need to do to keep from dipping your beard in your soup. Today's Mario Day. Didn't know today was Mario Day.
That's
interesting.
Active.
Is Mario Day in honor of Nintendo Mario? Song I was playing a while back when I was AFK. No clue. Sorry, no clue. So that guy is in a Tengu, pretty sure. Huh. Alright. What country is it officially celebrated in? Mario Day. There are some signatures in here. This guy camps us all the time.
Warp drive active. Docking permission requested. Docking request accepted.
NationalDayCalendar.com. Alright. The other systems that are easy to access, they're being camped. This one's being camped as well, but this guy is typically AFK. Oh my god, I'm really this far away? I'm probably told to land at zero. Guess not. We'll do a little cleanup here for a little bit. Going here. missile batteries are the biggest threat to me. This is an Ishtar, and a smart bombing fit. Pretty interesting one, too. Share it in live shows. Hello there, Thor.
What's up?
How you doing, buddy?
Just shitty like usual.
Oh, okay, great. Good to hear it.
Yes.
Yep.
So how's it going? So you're evening around?
Yes. Evening around. And we are just below Stain. Esoterra.
Yeah, I saw where you were earlier today. Yeah. I was seeing how far you were away from. So I was thinking about bringing a tomb you didn't know and start terrorizing you, work in and out of system.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
But I
so
was too lazy.
These four guys that are here, those are all you?
No. I was too lazy to go down there.
Oh yeah. Okay. Of course. Yeah, so, you know, it's been pretty interesting down here so far. We have a lot of cleanup to do. There are some enemy citadels and pauses in our area. And, because this is just newly won territory. So, they need to be cleaned up.
So you can't take over citadels, right? opportunity to destroy them.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, this was Russian space. So. Yep.
So where did the Russians go?
I don't know. Maybe more into Stain? There's a lot higher population in Stain at the moment.
Yeah, they, at least the Russians I was flying with a while back, they were in, relocated when they were driven away to Stain, and then they gathered their forces and rolled right back in again for them.
Yeah.
But that might be different Russians.
Aren't they all the same? I'm just kidding.
Hello.
Oh, hey, Brian. How's it going?
Doing fine. How about yourself?
Not bad.
Do you need to reapply?
Yeah. I should do that. Yeah, they're still rebuilding all the systems on the back end. They decided to purge everything and do a rebuild.
I was wondering about that. What?
Yeah. Yeah, I think it's not 100% done yet. I think it's close, but not 100% done yet.
Mm-hmm.
So, have you moved all your carriers and stuff down to Acid, Tony, whatever?
Esoteria? Yeah, I have 7 carriers down here. And 4 of them are fit. The others are in various stages of being fit. And my plan is that really I'd just be able to bounce around and leave them in a system, and if it's good to do work there, I can. If it's not, I just fly over to another place. So in our area here, there's a bit more strife. We're 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We're 7 jumps away from Stain. And one of 2 pipes from Stain. So there's a bit more activity here. So I'm just kinda using the thing of that I'll go wherever opportunity is.
Yeah. So you're planning to have a carrier in every station in EVE?
No, but I have like 2 carriers in this area here, and then I have another couple carriers other places in Esoterra, so that they're a good distance apart from each other. So these people who camp and harass aren't going to be interested in following me.
Are you sure about that?
yeah, pretty much. So. Yeah, I don't think it's, my experience so far hasn't been too bad. And I bought a couple other ships. I bought a Marauder and a couple of battleships. Just screw around with them. And then this Ishtar.
Yeah, I tried another. I mean, that, and I tried, I mean, I wasn't doing Havens in that, but I took a Pilgrim.
Mm-hmm.
That has drone bonuses, plus you can warp around in it cloaked. And it's a neutralizer ship.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, the MR one, you mean? Yeah.
Yeah, the MR, it's called, yeah.
Yeah, we have one of the guys that's been camping us is in a Pilgrim.
Yes. So yeah, that's a neutralizing drone ship. So and it has bonuses to drone damage and durability. I think 10% per each level.
Take a Gila down. I guess you can have a lot of fun with the Gila 2 down here. No.
Yeah. So. Well, like this Ishtar, I can run Sanctums with this. It just takes longer. The Healas seem to be running everything up to Havens and Sanctums. And a lot of Vexer Navy issue or Vexers running smaller sites like hubs. So yeah, Vexers are pretty cheap,
but good.
Yeah,
still pretty decent ships though.
Mhm. So we've had a couple people lose theirs down here. One person lost a couple of them to rats. And then we've only had a couple of hostiles come in here and get us. So, but they keep trying. We have some citadels down here and pauses that need to be taken out still. So, and I've been involved in taking out two citadels and a pause so far. So,
don't I think you were showing that on stream last time, right?
Yeah, I showed up. I mean, like, the very first shot I fired was at a citadel when I landed in system. It's like, okay, we're going to go look around, and, oh, here's a fleet. Oh, they're killing the citadel. Oh, they invited me. Yes, let's shoot, too. So, yeah, so it's not pronounced Gila. It's pronounced Gila, like an H. Dank Stwamp.
This is something I still don't understand with the pronunciation of some words sometimes.
Well, maybe it's just the American version. I don't know. There might be, you know, different for other countries.
No, just because of it, it's always like, obviously a G, but why do they say T? That does,
Right. Yeah.
I call it Gila. Exactly.
Yeah, the thing. Well, and I call it Gila. So.
Or maybe a rattlesnake. Maybe a rattlesnake down there.
Well, rattlesnakes do good here. National Geographic calls them Gilas. So. Yes, it's named after the Gila monster. Mm-hmm. Yeah, which is a very big lizard. And their saliva is very toxic. So, you do not want to get bit by one.
Is it the one that has such a huge amount of bacteria in the saliva?
Yes. Yes.
Yeah, okay. It's for killing, because they eat like carcasses and super rotten stuff. So, they have bacteria to start breaking their stuff down as it goes to the mouth or something like that.
Now I'm getting hungry.
Okay. So, I think after I finish this site, we're going to do a drawing. So, !! Ticket space 1 or higher in Twitch chat. And then we are going to be switching over to Paladins for a few hours. So.
What? Paladins?
Overwatch thingy. It's basically both games are the same.
They're very similar.
They're very similar. And a lot of people are saying it's a copy of that game. No, this is a copy of this game. It's a game like every other game.
I'm not getting into that.
Hey, it's at least free to play while you pay for Overwatch a shit ton of money.
True.
Overwatch is €40, the cheapest version, if you buy it from the stores directly, not over key selling sites or whatever.
I think Overwatch looks hideous and it's overly hyped copy of like Team Fortress or something.
Yeah, well, that's what they're both inspired by, is Team Fortress.
Yeah, so why don't you just play Team Fortress?
Well, when was the last time Team Fortress was released? How long ago was that?
Team Fortress 2 is still heavily played.
Yeah, right. It's heavily updated, and they're always putting up new content in the form of skins and that stuff.
That is quite impressive. Team Fortress 2 is doing pretty well.
Okay.
definitely worth a shot. Especially over Halloween and so on, when they have those funny events in the game as well.
So, Paladins. Is it any good?
It doesn't look bad. I mean, I was watching Marcus
it's a fun first-person shooter. I mean, you get into matches pretty quick.
Yeah, I mean, personally, I think, for example, Overwatch looks disgusting. Does it look anything like Overwatch? Or?
I don't know.
Yes. Partially. I mean,
it looks like Smite. It's similar to, it's made by the same people who made Smite, and so the graphic style is the same as Smite.
Yeah. That's true. It's from Hi-Rez Studios.
Yeah.
First game that I played from those guys was Global Agenda.
Oh yeah, I remember that.
Mm-hmm. What was the first game that I played from them?
This looks like first person World of Warcraft or something.
It doesn't look like World of Warcraft, not even close.
That's the first impression of what I see, what I think when I saw the game. I looked at the video on YouTube.
Yeah. But it doesn't look bad, to be honest.
Okay, well, finished another one.
So I can reapply, they said, right?
Uh-huh, yeah.
Okay.
Yep.
Hopefully I will get all the details done.
Yeah, well, don't count on it. I mean, get into Slack, and that's the main place, and when you're confused about anything, ask there, and you'll get an answer.
Now, the thing is, I didn't even know about that channel or whatsoever. There were no informations about that at all.
Yeah.
Just write some person of the guild, of the corp, about this, and they will set up an account for you. And okay, nothing was happening. The person could not receive any mails because of filters.
Hmm. Okay. Well. Yeah.
Docking permission
requested. You want me to fly a Revenant, or you're going to riot? You're going to have to riot, because I don't own a Revenant. So... Okay, let's do a drawing here, folks. And Danith and Just Garbage, thank you for following. Welcome. So, last call, exclamation point, ticket space 1 or higher in Twitch chat. It's going to get you on a brand new account for EVE, worth about $20, and it comes from our store. Exclamation point, coupon in Twitch chat if you need any Plex or Aurum. There's some discount and bonus codes there that will... save you a few bucks, and any purchases from us help support the show. So, getting this written up, then we'll draw, and then we are going to switch games here. I found three different characters that I really like within Paladins, so...
Is this Paladins beta or something?
Yeah, but it's been out for a year.
It's free to play, so you don't need to pay anything to...
Yeah, but why is it still beta then? Is it going to be wiped, or...?
No, I don't think there's going to be a wipe.
Why the fuck is it a beta?
I don't know, why don't you ask them?
Why? Where can I ask them?
Say, I am Thor. I am here to know why.
Why the fuck is this still beta?
Well, no, you don't even have to say that. You just say, I'm here to know why, and see what they say. Welcome to the dragons.
I must say, I'd rather have a game longer in beta than having a game released that is said it's a full release title and it feels like an alpha version, to be quite honest with you.
Yes.
I mean, I just take a look at the releases from a company called U... and the last release... 2 years ago and this year were a disaster, in my opinion, because the games are not even considerably close towards a release title.
Barely playable then.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm closing this raffle and drawing. Synchronos. Congratulations, Synchronos. You had a 6% chance to win. You got it. All right. So, Synchronos, check your Twitch mail. You'll find that contained within. All right. Now, what do I got to do next here? I probably need to execute this other game. And those of you watching in YouTube, I have a new URL for you. It will not auto-switch. I wish it would. It will not auto-switch. And so that is the new URL for you in YouTube chat. And we will be over there in just a moment. And Porsk, yes, thank you for the welcome to test. Mega Matt, thank you for following. Okay. I've just been promoted to Fleet Boss. Well, everybody else is about to be promoted too. So, yes. So, all right. Okay, so, I'll re-enable comms here in just a moment. Be right back. And we will see you in Paladins in just a moment. And those of you who want to get in, hop into Discord. I'm going to give priority to people in Discord. Be right back.